Hey everyone, Shabby Game here, and welcome back to the WWE 2K15 Universe Mode, and this, which is the next episode of the WWF Retros Throwback Thursday. So let's have a quick look at the card we've got set for you this evening. We're going to start off with Demolition, Axe and Smash, taking on the Triangle of Terror, General Adnan and Colonel Mustafa, and Sergeant Slaughter will be at ringside. Our second match will see the Ultimate Warrior take on Rick Rude. In match number 3, Ric Flair will take on Randy Savage. In match 4, we have Big Van Vader taking on the British Bulldog. And our main event this evening will be Hulk Hogan, the current WWF Champion, taking on The Undertaker. So let's get straight into our first match. And here we go. We're going to start off with Smash and Colonel Mustafa in the ring. Triangle of Terror have only recently joined the Universe Mode a few weeks back. Not had the best of times, defeated the Legion of Doom. However, I still don't think they're in the top four of the tag team rankings as of yet. Demolition are only in third place themselves. I think the current number one contenders are the Legion of Doom and then the Hart Foundation. Bret Hart and Owen Hart are just behind them. And then obviously we've got Demolition. Then in fourth place, I think it's the British Bulldogs. However, with Bret Hart tied up looking for the WWF Championship, and it looks like British Bulldogs tied up with Big Van Vader. That only leaves us really with the Triangle of Terror, Demolition, and Legion of Doom going after the Blade Runners Tag Team Championships. Mustafa comes across and brings in General Adnan, also known as the Iron Sheik. A Smash brings in Axe as well. And there's Adnan with a shoulder block. Big punch there by Axe. Taking Adnan down. Adnan throwing Axe straight over to Mustafa though. Mustafa catches him and Adnan gets the opportunity to just poke Axe in the eye. And then just a big overarm. Almost like a forearm to the face. And a big punch to the face again, this again by Adnan. There's the boot to the inside thigh. Brings Axe back to his feet, and Triangle of Terror are in control of this match at the moment. And there's the commentator's curse, maybe not. As Adnan just slamming Axe's face. It looked like he was going to slam it against the mat, but I think his head actually caught the bottom rope, which is not fun at all. Adnan with a vertical suplex now on Axe as well. Followed up by that elbow drop. Adnan brings Axe back to his feet. And there's the belly-to-belly slam. Triangle of Terror dominating this match. As I said, a victory here has got to start pushing them up these tag team rankings. As I said, only three teams really look available to go into the championship match at SummerSlam. Remember, that is only in 2.5 weeks' time, SummerSlam. It is the first week of next month. We have Global Force Wrestling's pay-per-view this week. Next week, we've got Money in the Bank for the current day roster. And the week after that, we do have our Retro SummerSlam. Now, we've got some matches set up for you already. I can't remember them now. I think we're going to have The Undertaker versus Kane. As we saw a few weeks back, Paul Bearer brought back Kane. We're also going to have... is it Randy Savage versus Diesel? After Diesel attacked Savage. Remember, Diesel was not part of this roster, but he came out and attacked Savage during a match. Also, Bret Hart versus Hulk Hogan for the WWF Championship. Still looking for a number one contender for Owen Hart's Intercontinental Championship as well. So we're going to have a packed out card for you, really. Looks like British Bulldog and Vader may end up in a match there as well. Knee to the stomach and now Smash with the Atomic Drop. Rolling Mustafa over. Mustafa fighting his way back, and Sergeant Slaughter up on the apron there. Looked like Mustafa was going to try and tag in Adnan, but Adnan it was who manages to make the blind tag and bring himself into this match. Caught Smash unawares for a couple of seconds, but Smash back in control. Smash there with a clothesline on Adnan. Brings him back to his feet. And I think I've already said this on a couple of the other videos, but if you don't watch them, Just interested in what's going to happen when we finally get the roster reveal for 2K16. Whether we're going to have a retro group of wrestlers. I know that I know we've got a larger roster. We're going to have almost double the roster on the new game as what was on this one. So it'll be interesting to see where they're going to get them extra names from. Because there's only so many guys on the up-to-date roster. And obviously we'll have a chunk of guys from NXT as well, I believe. But yeah, it'll be interesting to see where they're going to get the rest from. And again, how many core slots we get. Because that's really going to define how we do this universe mode next year. We need lots of core spaces. And a very, very varied roster of all different types. I've got a feeling it's going to be attitude-based since it's based on Stone Cold Steve Austin. So we might get, who knows, we might even get a chunk of WCW guys, a chunk of ECW guys. They'll have to work it around that way. As Adnan hits a great Saito suplex on Smash. Mustafa's taken Axe off the apron. This could be all. One, two. Oh, only a two count. Smash kicks out. Thought that could be it for Triangle of Terror there. They nearly had the victory. There's the elbow to the face. Now just throws Adnan into the corner. And Smash finally makes the tag into Axe. The hot tag, unsuccessful as normal. God, these hot tags are just depressing, aren't they, sometimes? Great full Nelson submission hold by Adnan. Smash was across quickly and managed to get Adnan to break it. Axe now with the atomic drop on Adnan. Is he signaling for here? Smash tried to catch Mustafa unaware. And he did a good job. Mustafa was distracted by Smash, giving Axe the opportunity to lock in the chicken wing submission on General Adnan. And Adnan had to tap out. And that is all here. Demolition defeats the Triangle of Terror in our opening match this evening. There was that Saito suplex, which I thought may have finished the match off. Only for a two count, though. As we see here. And then it was this chicken wing. You see Smash try and catch Mustafa unaware. Mustafa manages to duck Smash, and Smash comes flying out the ring, but he distracts him long enough for Axe to lock in the chicken wing submission and pick up the victory. Good win here for Demolition. Definitely putting themselves in a strong position for this tag team championship match at SummerSlam. We'll have to crown our number one contenders in sometime over the next 2 weeks, surely. Match number two of the evening is going to be the Ultimate Warrior taking on Rick Rude. And here we go. As we've just seen the tag team match earlier on, Demolition versus Triangle of Terror. In this match, we see one half of the tag team champions, the Ultimate Warrior, taking on Rick Rude. The Warrior, half of the tag team championships alongside Sting as the Blade Runners. Rick Rude, one of the newer guys into this roster, came in with a DLC a few weeks back. Not had a massive opportunities as yet. However, I think he may very well be involved in the number one contendership process for the Intercontinental Championship. That'd be an interesting situation for him to be in. Alongside the likes of Jake Roberts, the former Intercontinental Champion. We've also got Honky Tonk Man was a great Intercontinental Champion. Looks like Savage is going to be tied up, like we said, with Diesel, so he's out of the equation. Maybe even Dynamite Kid, we can maybe do a four-way elimination match to become the number one contender to face Owen Hart at SummerSlam. There's the pin, only for the one count, though. Elbow drop by Rude. Warrior back to his feet. Rude catches him, then gets around the back. Warrior fights back with the two back elbows. Rude though with a belly-to-belly slam. You'd have to say that Warrior was the favourite in this match. However, you can't write him off, Rude. I've forgotten his name, that's why I stumbled there for a second. Rick Rude. Not Bobby Rude, Rick Rude. Atomic drop by Warrior. Brings Rude back to his feet, and there's the gorilla press. Has him up and drops him down hard. Very close to the ropes, though. Pulls him into the center of the ring. Is this extra time going to affect him? Going for the pin. One, two. Yes, it does affect him. Only a two count. Rude managed to kick out. You've got to think if Warrior had managed to hit that gorilla press more central into the ring and got the pin straight away, he may have picked up the victory there. There's Rude with a big DDT. Pulls Warrior into the center of the ring. Goes to the pin. One, two. Only a two count. Rick Rude hits the neck breaker now on Warrior as well. Straight into the pin. Quite a cocky pin, may I add. And there's the freak out. And that's a huge victory here for Rick Rude over one half of the tag team champions, the Ultimate Warrior. That's a very big victory, and that definitely puts him in the Intercontinental picture, if you ask me. Defeating one of the most iconic Intercontinental champions, the Ultimate Warrior, here in a singles match, cleanly as well. And that was the neckbreaker that finished it off, and just floats straight over into that pin for the free count. Fantastic win for Rick Rude. As I said, not expected to win this match by any stretch of the imagination, but was never going to be a massive underdog. But yeah, it's a big win. Maybe there could be a championship in his future. Who knows? Match number three this evening is me, Ric Flair taking on Randy Savage. And here we go. Flair and Savage kicking things off. Savage is having a good start, and there's the elbow across the back of the shoulder of Flair. Now going for a shin breaker as well early on. Obviously, if the shin of Flair is damaged, it's not going to be able to put as much pressure on the figure four leg lock as he'd want to in the future, should he get the opportunity, that is. Flair throwing Randy into the corner. Randy fighting his way out with a boot the stomach, but Flair catches him, that twist of the arm. Knee to the stomach now by Macho Man. There's a clothesline. Catches Flair in the front chancery, but Flair picks him up and drops him flat on his face in the middle of the ring. Flair now with a belly-to-belly slam. Again, just bringing Savage back to his feet, and Savage again with a belly-to-belly slam. Both these guys know each other very well. Reversing reversals. Then again, this game loves a good reversal to a reversal. I have just a quick random bit on next year's game as well. I have read somewhere that they are bringing in some sort of momentum into the game, where at the beginning of the game there'll be lots of reversals and lots of energetic moves. Then as the match gets a little bit further in, reversals will slow down, and I think there's slightly different animations for slightly more tired versions of moves. And then as you get even further into the match, I think there's a third stage where reversals are even slimmer chance, and I think there's more animations for really sloppy and tired looking moves, as well as just like general moving around the ring and things like that as well, which to me sounds good, because I've seen on several occasions guys get put through the announce table. I don't know why the game's got... It's nice, the idea that someone can go through the announce table, but the way the game just does it set that it happens like one in every 10 or 20 matches someone goes through the announce table, so it's a bit too common for me. But even when it does happen, you'd think that they should be down for a long time. I've seen people get put for the announce table and they're back up within 2 seconds on their feet, not showing any damage at all. So that's quite frustrating, isn't it, really? That's quite frustrating, isn't it? It's quite frustrating. I don't know why I've gone Scottish for. Answers on a postcard to Aberdeen. Jawbreaker by Ric Flair. Two guys locking up again in the centre of the ring. It's Savage who comes out on top, twisting the arm of Flair. Now there's that backdrop. Knee drop to the face of Flair as well. Flair back to his feet, Savage around the back. Flair reverses into the snapmare. The snap Flair. Savage rake to the eyes. That's a very Flair style move, but Savage has used it now. Knee to the face on Flair. Flair brought back to his feet. Flair catches Macho Man in the headlock. Went for the chop. Macho Man reverses. Then as Macho Man ran towards Flair, he threw him straight at the top of his head. Flair now catching the leg of Savage and then just wrenching it over the top. Obviously looking to do some damage for that potential figure four leg lock. Following it up with that running DDT. But again, a rake to the eyes by Savage, but wasn't it enough as Flair catches him with that hip toss. Savage back to his feet again. Throws Flair into the corner face first. Takes him up onto the top. Was he a planned here? He follows him up there. He's got him hooked and drops him in a super backdrop. Brings him back to his feet. Flair fighting his way back there with that back elbow. Quick roll up by Macho Man. Could that super backdrop be enough? And no, only a two count. One of the things that does annoy me a little bit in this game as well is I've noticed that if somebody does have a finisher from the top rope, they never seem to use it. I've not seen Adrian Neville, computer versus computer, go for the red arrow once yet. I'm just thinking that because obviously Macho Man's finisher is an elbow drop. Are we going to get to see that? I don't know. We'll have to wait and see, I suppose. Boot to the stomach by Macho Man. And just some big, big punches. Flair looks rocked and Flair goes down hard with a final punch. Macho Man trying to prove me wrong by going to the top rope. Signaling for his, I thought it was signaling for his elbow. It wasn't, signaling for a double axe handle. But either way, that could be enough. Flair looks down and out. Got caught with a double axe handle. One, two, three. And it is Macho Man Randy Savage victorious here against Ric Flair. Flair just throwing Savage at the top of his head. It was a quick roll up by Savage earlier on, in here for a two count though. And that was a punch. That was a kick to the stomach. Big replay that was. I think it's trying to show that Macho Man may have avoided a move by Flair, and then Flair gets caught with a double axe handle from the top. Not the most coherent of finishes, but it's effective. A Macho Man Randy Savage victorious here. Great victory for him as well, just like Rick Rude in the last match. Savage defeating Ric Flair. It's a great victory for Savage. Gonna have his hands tied at SummerSlam with Big Daddy Cool Kevin Nash Diesel. However, tonight he picks up a great boost in momentum against Ric Flair. And match number four here this evening is going to be Big Van Vader taking on the British Bulldog. And here we go, Vader versus Bulldog. And I must admit, I've not had Vader for very long. I only had him for a couple of weeks on this Universe mode, but I think he is one of my favourite cores. He's definitely looks like who he should do. We saw the debut of Yokozuna last week, and I have to apologise, I've struggled, and that was the best Yokozuna I could find, so we will replace him with somebody else, because I'd rather have someone good than somebody not up to standards, as Bulldog just walks out here on Vader. But Vader follows him straight back out there, and it was a trick as Bulldog takes out the leg of Vader. Now Bulldog has the ring steps. Throws him into the ring and catches Vader, but Vader doesn't even go down. Remember, this is not a no disqualification match. This is a normal match. Referee just taking them ring steps out of the ring. Over Vader, looks to have gained control over Bulldog. He says as Bulldog tripping Vader. Now just wrenching that knee and slamming it into the mat. And again, just working on that leg of Vader, trying to keep the big man down, but not effective as the big man's back up to his feet and taken straight back down again by Bulldog. And now Vader returning the favor with that huge elbow drop to the inside of the knee of Bulldog. Bulldog back to his feet. Vader now around the back of Bulldog, spins him round. Russian leg sweep by Bulldog. Yeah, as I was saying, we will replace Yokozuna pretty soon with somebody. If any of you guys have any suggestions of who you think would be a good addition to this retro roster, let me know. I'm looking for one guy. One guy we can maybe use as a top card talent. Maybe even Intercontinental. Got a lot of tag teams here at the moment. We've got a few sort of, I don't want to say useless guys, but I don't know what we got. Colonel Mustafa is always going to be a tag team wrestler. There's nothing else he's ever going to do. We could get Baob Adnan as the Iron Sheik, but still not the greatest pin here for Vader. Only a two count. I'm trying to think of people myself now. I've seen Big John Studd and people like that on there, but not sure if that's the right time frame we're looking at. Bulldog now has Vader up on his shoulders, showing his strength and hitting that running power slam. And Bulldog could be victorious here. One, two, only a two count. Big Van Vader kicks out. Bulldog round the back of Vader, now dropping him with a backdrop as well. Vader fighting his way back up to his feet now. Bulldog with a headlock, back elbow. And Vader has Bulldog up and drops him in the huge choke slam. One, two, three, and it's Vader who's victorious against the British Bulldog by means of that big choke slam. I can't believe British Bulldog Davey Boy Smith managed to get Vader up on his shoulders and hit that running power slam. But Vader from the chokeslam picks up the victory for the three count. Big win for Big Van. As I say, I see this feud moving up into SummerSlam. It's a big finale. So yeah, I'm very much liking Vader. I think he's a great addition to this retro roster. So we do have one space for someone else. So if you have any ideas, just looking for one guy who could bolster this roster, because we're still struggling. It's not the strongest roster. It's nowhere near the same quality as some of the others. And now we're going to our main event this evening. It's Hulk Hogan versus The Undertaker. And here comes Bret Hart. He's going to sit here on commentary and watch the current champion, Hulk Hogan, face off against The Undertaker. Is that going to distract Hogan at all, or will he be okay? We'll soon find out. Great big boot by Taker. Taker will be distracted himself. Of course, he was attacked by Paul Bearer a few weeks back on his debut after a victory, I think it was, as well. A couple of weeks after that, Paul Bearer returned with Kane. And Kane went on to face Taker. I think Taker came out victorious again. We were not seeing Kane since then. We know that Kane will return and face Taker at SummerSlam. So Taker's got a lot on his mind. Hogan, of course, a lot on his mind as well, with his number one contender for his WWF Championship out there at ringside, Bret Hart. Bret Hart, of course, earning this championship match I think he won a Fatal 4-Way a few weeks back. Sorry, it's been a... I record that many episodes of that many different rosters, I lose track sometimes of what's going on. I'm sure he won a Fatal 4-Way. Can't remember for the life of me who was in that, but... he was trying to get himself a championship match as it was anyway. I think he attacked Hogan during his entrance a couple of weeks after the last pay-per-view United Champions. Then he earned his title shot in that Fatal 4-Way elimination match. Hogan just kicking Taker away. Taker with a running DDT. I keep seeing that guy in the front row. See the guy with the what? He's just sat down now. The watch shirt and the bandana. He's behind the referee now. I'm sure that's New Jack. Back up to his feet now, waving. I'm sure that's New Jack. So I'm just looking at all the people in the crowd. I'm not even paying attention to what's happening in the ring. Running DDT by The Undertaker. I can see a few New Jacks further back in the arena as well. Yeah, I'm sure that's New Jack. There's the big, big punch by Hogan. Took Taker down. Taker back to his feet, though. Hits the running big boot. Hogan's back up and catches Taker with the atomic drop. Nut first on the knee. No, an elbow drop to the inside of the knee of Taker as well. Hogan brings Taker back to his feet. Taker blocking the strikes. Catches Hogan with a headlock, but Hogan reverses with that backdrop. Hogan was taunting while Taker was grounded, but now Hogan looks like he's hulking up here. You! There's the bionic punches. Irish whips Taker off the far ropes. Hits him with a big boot. And here's the big follow-up. The atomic leg drop. Could that be all? But he tried to follow... Why didn't Hogan go for the pin there? He hit the atomic leg drop and he tried to follow up with a stupid elbow drop. Or if he'd gone for the pin, he might have finished the whole match off. Taker now just... great submission there. Just gripping a hold of the vein in the neck of Hogan. Hogan tripping Taker. Elbow to the inside of the knee by Hogan. And I still can't understand why he didn't go for the pin straight from the atomic leg drop. Wherever he was trying to send a message to Bret Hart here on our outside the ring. If he has, it's definitely backfired. As now Taker's up on the top rope going for old school and hits it beautifully, even if the ropes did glitch out. Taker going for a pin. One, two. Only a two count. Hogan kicks out. Taker with a knee to the stomach. Went for the big boot, but Hogan reverses into that hip toss. Followed by some punches to the face. Taker tripping Hogan. And now signaling for a chokeslam. You've got to think that Bret Hart's loving this here outside at the announce table. Taker has him up and slams him down. One, two, three. And The Undertaker cleanly pins the WWF champion Hulk Hogan here on Throwback Thursday. As I said, you've got to think that Bret Hart was in the head of Hogan, but that's a clean victory. They say Taker's got his hands full at SummerSlam against his little brother Kane. However, after that, he's going to have to be a serious contender for this championship. Clean victory over the champion and the icon of this roster. Even if he is a little racist, it's definitely a good win for Undertaker. And there's the freak out from the chokeslam. Undertaker celebrates in the center of the ring. Message to Kane there, you can see he'd be very happy with this win, but you've got to think again, his mind is firmly placed on Kane at SummerSlam in a couple of weeks' time. Well, anyway, guys, that is the end of this episode of the WWF Retros Throwback Thursday. It's been a great episode, and thank you very much for watching. I've been Shabby Gamer, and goodbye.